Patrick, can you hear me? Patrick, can you hear me? Hello? Please respond. Can you hear me, Patrick? Hello? Hello, Patrick? Are you there? Okay, you are on mute, so if you are speaking, I cannot hear you. Pramod, can you please check if he is available? Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Satvik? Hello? Satvik, are you there?
I can hear you.
Okay, great. Thank you. You came back. Okay, so today we are going to talk about using the classes, right? Because you cannot write a program in Java without using a class, like you are using a class here. Right, but we have not been using the instances, which are the objects. Okay, in object-oriented programming, we work on classes and objects. Okay. So, what is a class? class is a group of objects which have common properties. Okay. And if you go through some of the books or on programming languages, you will also see that a definition like it's a template or it's a blueprint from which the objects are created. Okay. So a class in Java can contain basically it's a blueprint. It's a blueprint of objects from which, or you can say from which the object has created, or you can say blueprint, it's a template from which the objects are created. Class in Java can contain the following. So a class can have following properties. A class can have attributes in the form of data types, right? And you already know what are data types. Then it can have methods. So methods like we use the methods like the method main method. We have been using the public static void main. Main is the method here. So methods. Then we can, it can have constructors. We'll study about constructors later on. Okay. It can have different blocks, and then it can have classes, the other classes, and interfaces. Study later. So it can have more classes. It can have subclasses. A class can have another class, and that will be a subclass. Okay. What is the, so far is it clear, Sattvic?
Yeah.
The syntax of a class goes like, you will say public, and then you will say the keyword which is class, and then name of class, and then it will have curly braces open, then close, then attributes in the form of data types, and then the methods. Now we have written many programs so far, and then so what if we want to add two numbers using classes and objects? How do we do that? So we will first of all, as I said, we'll have a class, so public class, add two numbers, right? Curly braces open, then it's working on two integers, right? X, integer Y, we are going to add them, and then a resultant. Then a resultant which will again be an integer, so if I say now we have a method to display the result of it, public void display. Okay. So display the we display our result. Let's say x plus y. Or store the x plus y in this and then we can display it. Then we have every program must have the main part. Without main, because the moment you the moment Java starts compiling the program, first of all it connects with the main method, so it will look for the main method. So we must have public static void main string args. Now the methods can be can have parameters, and the methods can also be can have parameters, and they can also be as default, like they cannot have parameters. So the methods are of two types: without parameters and then with parameters. Okay, right now we will just see it as without parameters. So we are going to initialize it. Let's say x equals to 6, and then we will later on we will also use the parameterize methods. Okay, and y equals to 5. Okay, here we are adding it. Now if I say here system dot out dot print line, what is the sum of two numbers? Sum of two numbers. So what is the sum of two numbers? So first of all, we need to create, and where is the sum being displayed? Under the display method. In order to see this result x plus y, we need to access this method. And how will we access this method? We will need to create an instance of this class add two numbers. In order to access the result method, result located in the display method, we need to access the method. And how will we access that method? We will need to create an instance of the class, right? So add two numbers, how do we create the instance? First of all, we will just copy paste the name of the class and then say this is a user defined, so it can be anything. I can also say anything. S is my object, equals to new will be the new instance of the class. Then again add two numbers. This is how you write it while instantiating a class, while creating an object of a class. Then the object of the class will refer the items of the class. So s dot means you are referencing the item of this class. So item of this class displays one of the items. I'm going to refer that using the object of this class. So s dot display. Is it understandable, Sattvic, so far?
Yeah.
Cool. So we will need to create another class here. Test one or test two. we have been working in this one. Okay, so let's create another class. The name of the class is add numbers public, and it will have the main method. I will click on finish. Okay, and then I will just copy and paste whatever I have. Yes, this string should be capitalized and everything else looks fine. And I will just run this program. Dot Java. Java application comes from the local. Okay, what is the sum of two numbers? So it's 11. Okay. So this is how you create a class, and then you create an instance, an object of the class, and then you access using that object, you access the items of that class. Clear so far? Okay, now here what I did, I defined two items, right? I used I had two data types, and both were integers. I initialized them, then I just accessed the output of that. Okay, so I just created an object, name of the class, then my object was the letter S, right? So there are multiple ways to initialize an object in Java. Okay, so basically there are three ways to initialize the objects. One is reference variable, other is method, and the next one is by constructor. So I will just write it for your convenience. Just type it here. So there are three ways to initialize an object in Java. First is to the reference. First is to the reference that you just did. First is the reference that you just, we just worked on that. Like we use the dot notation. Okay, let me just copy it. Let me control myself. So in this program we use the dot notation, is dot display. We are referencing it. This is one of the methods. There are two more ways to initialize, right? The other one is initializing two methods. Okay, so how do we initialize two methods? We will need to create methods for that, and then we can initialize it. For an example, you have constructors. Okay, let me just write a program and then I will explain it to you. Okay, so the other one is to reference, the other one is to methods. So for reference, you have just seen we use the dot notation. Now I'm going to show you an example by which I will be explaining you how you can initialize an object in Java through methods. So I will say public class student. I will just give some integer value here because we already have I have an integer class. Or let's say student. Let's keep it as student. We will just add the code in the previous program in Eclipse. So int roll number, string name, word in search record, and path, and then the name and the string. I will explain everything once I have typed it here. One number is R and name is string. Now let me have another method here. Like we can have display method here. I like very much. I use this in all my sessions, the display method. So outdoor display, let's display the roll number, the roll number and the name. Number plus concatenating the name. So we have a name here, that's the name. This is our one of the classes, right? Now what I'll do is since this is a public class, I can use this, I can refer this class in some using some other classes, right? What I can do is I'll go and create some other class, like let's say class so don't be puzzled, Sakshi. I will explain this once I have completed this. So what I can do here, okay. Oh, so let's understand this. Satvik, you're there? You can hear me, right? Satvik? Okay, so what I have done here, I have first created a class. It has an attribute, two attributes, roll number and the name of the student. Okay. Now, in the previous example, I said there are parameterized methods and there are methods which are without parameters. So I have used another method here which has two parameters, integer r and string name. Okay. Why I have used the parameterized? So that I can pass some value. So that I can pass some value while creating the object. Okay. So here you can see I have assigned this r integer to the roll number this one, and the letter n to the name. Okay. And then I have passed some value here in the insert record, 12 to the integer value and Ryan to the string value, 11 to the integer value, Gopi to the string value, 101 to the integer value and Salesforce to the string value. Okay. Because I wanted to pass some value using instantiating my class, that's why I use the parameters in my method. Okay. So here the purpose of this method is just to initialize my data members, my attributes. And the purpose of the display method is to whatever it has been it has initialized, the insert record method, the display method will help to print out them. Okay. So this was just a separate class where I have just initialized my attributes and assigned them to methods, and then I have displayed them here. In my other class, I have created instance of this student class because that is public. Public means public is one of the access modifiers which allows you to access the class or any data variable which is public. It will be accessed within the organization anywhere, in any other program, in any package. Okay. So I have created three objects in my other class. Student, see the name of this student refers to the class student here. In case student, I have created instances for the student class. So S1, S2, S3. These are the instances of three separate students. So three separate students will have three separate data, right? Everyone will have different roll numbers and different names, right? We are inserting it and then we are displaying it for all of them. Let's see this in Eclipse. So just copying it here. I'll first go to the student one. Go here at the end and then we will have to remove this because we have already created this about. Okay, so good now. but there is, it's not going to display anything right now. If I run this, it is just displaying the result of the active numbers. Okay. The main method not found in the class, that's why it's not displaying anything at the moment. Okay, you can hear me, Sapit? Okay, so there is not any main method, so we will create another class where we will have our main method. So let's go here again in the same package for Java training, and then we will create another class. What's that? Student will have the name. Okay. Now it tells the student. Now the test student will have the instance of the student class. Not doing anything, just I copied and pasted all of that stuff. Okay. Now you will be accessing this one, the test student, not the student one, because we have the main in test student. Look at this, 12 Ryan, 11 Gopi, 101 Salesforce. These are the three instances. Okay. So these are the two ways. These are the two different ways to, like through the reference and through the methods we can access. We can instantiate the objects. Now the third way is to instantiate it by using the constructors. So what are the constructors? First, okay, so far is it clear?
Clear. Yeah.
Okay. Now wait. So we need to understand what are the constructors, then only we can understand how do we instantiate it by using the constructors. Okay. Before that, I want you to do some exercise on this classes, on class. Like what you can do is create a class. I will just guide you step by step here. You'll have to create a class. Name of the class will be candidate. You will have two attributes, length and width. You will have a method, okay, calculate. So it will display the area of the rectangle. Now in the main part we will create three instances of this class. Help you to show three different area based on three different inputs. So if you want to pass values, you will have to use parameters in the calculate area method. Okay, so you will be like you have length and breadth here, so you will be saying length, another variable, and then you have width, another variable for the width, and then you will be assigning length equals to length and width equals to width, like we just did. But the difference between the previous program and this one is, we are going to do it just in one class. We will not create two classes. We'll do this rectangle, length and width will have attributes, one method calculate area, then we will create three instances in the main where we will pass three different values for length and width, which will be giving us different outputs, the results. Okay.
Okay.
Can you do it? Right.
Sure.
Okay. Wait. Sadhvi, please let me know when you are done. Okay. Yes, can you please repeat yourself, Sarthak?
What?
Yeah, you said something?
I need your help on this.
Okay, okay. So, what is the problem you are facing? Anything in specific?
I define the variables length and width. So, after that, what do I do?
Okay, you defined it. Now, you will have a method, calculate area. Okay, do you have it in your program? So, just say void. Okay, then you have two parameters, integer length and integer width, right?
Yeah.
Now, in this, what you are going to do is, you will say length equals to length and width equals to width. It. Now in this, you will have another method here to display the area. So, I will just say my method is display area. Okay. So, area of the rectangle is what? Area of the rectangle is L into B. So L into B, like length into width. Multiply. So far, clear? So far, is it clear? Now, you go to the main part. In the main part, what do you do? In the main part, you create the instance. You will say rectangle, name of the class. Then you will have area 1 because you want to give different inputs. New rectangle. Then you will say rectangle. Area 2, new instance, is it
my script says the void calculate area is wrong.
What is wrong?
The void calculate area.
Okay, because there should be a comma here. Okay, so this is not whatever I'm writing here. This is, I'm just trying to help you, not writing it in a way you can copy and just paste it and it will run. Okay, it may have some errors. I want you to find it and fix it. Okay, I'm just giving you the logic. Okay, so area 3, whatever I'm doing here, new rectangle, area 3, is it understandable why I'm doing this?
Yeah.
Then you'll have area 1 dot calculate area. Then you will pass the value for length and breadth for the area 1, right? So I will say 2 is my length, 4 is my breadth. Then area 2 dot calculate area. So I have 10 and 20. Okay. Then I have area 3. For this I have 30, 20. Okay. So it will calculate area 1, area 2 and area 3. But it will not display them. When will when is it going to display? It will only display it when we will access the display area method for all these three instances. So again, we need to access it. Area one dot, making sense, Satvik? Why we are doing this?
Yeah.
Right now we are done with this, so there are a few syntactical errors that you need to find and fix. Like in the main, there should be string arguments, then it should be public static void main, right? Display area will be void display area, so you need to fix them. Can you do that?
Yeah.
And after this, I have given you, after this one, I'm going to explain one more program, which is kind of homework for you for tomorrow. We'll have to create, so just listen to me carefully. You'll have to create a class. The name of the class is account, bank account. Basically, this program is for the bank account. So it will have attributes, account number, name of the account holder, and the amount. Okay. It will have three methods: deposit, to deposit amount, to withdraw amount, to check balance. Okay. In the deposit amount, what will it do? It will ask how much do you want to deposit. So the customer will say, I want to deposit 10,000. So what it will do is, it will, whatever the amount he wants to deposit, it will be added to the amount, okay? And then it will display that your amount, after depositing this, your amount becomes this much now. Then in the case of withdrawal, when the how much do you want to withdraw? I want to withdraw 10,000. So if the amount is, it will do if and else. If he wants to withdraw 10,000, the amount should be at least 10,000 in his account. So if he is withdrawing 10,000 and he doesn't have 10,000 in his bank account, it will say insufficient balance. You cannot withdraw this much. If he has 10,000 or more than that, it will allow him to withdraw, and then it will display the rest of the amount. Check balance will just tell him the amount, what amount he has right now. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. So I think you will find it a little difficult because you have not done any program so far. So finish this one first, the rectangle one, and then you will find it easier.
What?
The rectangle one. For the rectangle one, finish that one first, and then you will find this one easy. Okay?
Okay. So, should I put my last week program in the chat?
You want this in the chat?
Oh, my last week homework.
We will talk about that. We will talk about that. First, finish this. on the surface. Please let me know when you are done with the rectangle program. Okay. Sarpi, can you hear me? Yes, please let me know when you are done. Are you done? Something?
Almost.
Okay. Okay, so Satvik, can you please give me the code, whatever you have written?
What?
Are you done?
Oh,
are you facing any challenge, seeing any error message, anything?
I'm seeing some error messages.
Okay, okay, let's see what you are doing. I'm making you the presenter, please share your screen. Okay, so please scroll it up. Okay, so length, scroll it up at extreme top, okay. See, the length, you have two sections. In the public void main, in the main section, you just instantiate your class, and then you use the reference object to access the items of your class, right? You define the attributes and the methods in the class part, not in the main part. Main is a method. So integer length, integer width, it should be defined in the rectangle in the class part. So just select it, cut it and paste it above in the rectangle part. After the curly braces, hit enter and paste it. Okay. Now, can I access your keyboard? Is there a way you can give me access to your keyboard and mouse? Do you see anything? Okay, no problem. Now do one thing. So there is one more thing that you have done wrong, which I see length equals to length, width equals to width. So this is a part of calculate area method, right? So just select it till the curly braces, and cut it. Go at the top, okay, and now type void calculate area, okay, then small brackets, open and close, don't worry, I will fix it. And then start a curly braces after the closure, start a curly braces and close it below. In between, paste whatever you have just copied and cut. Paste it, yeah. Now this length and width, again you have errors because you need to define them. You need to have parameters, length and width. To define two parameters, length and width, in the small curly brackets of calculate area. In the calculate area, go in that bracket and define length and width. These are two integers. Int length, comma int width. Okay? Space. Now scroll it down. So, okay, stop it. Now you see there is a closed curly braces above here in between before the rectangle. So remove it. Because here, there is no meaning of closing it here. It should be closed at the end of the program. Scroll it down. Okay. Scroll it down. Scroll it down at the bottom, extreme bottom. Okay, see, it's saying you do not have this, you should define these two methods. You have just defined calculate area, but you have not defined display area, right? So select all this private void display area and everything at the bottom till the bottom, and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Delete. Okay, now scroll it up. Scroll it up a little more. Go to the class section. Go to the class section at the top. Okay, now you have defined your calculate area. Now you also need to define display area. One more method. So void display area. Now start the curly bracket and close it. Whatever the curly bracket you start, you also need to close it. In between, display the area. So system.out.println. The area is length multiply width. So area equals to, so you have done correct, area equals to, but you need to also concatenate the equals to and the value, the multiplication of these two. So the area equal to length and width, and then say give a space before the closure of the inverted comma. Give a space where you have closed the inverted comma, give a space, then inverted comma, close it, and then say plus small bracket, start the small bracket, and then say length multiply width. So length length. Okay. Okay. So looks all right. Now scroll it down. Okay. Again it's saying there is some issue. Calculate area. Okay. What is the error message? See. Okay. Good. Scroll it down till the end of the program. Just want to see if there is more. Okay, remove it. It's asking to remove it. Scroll it up now. Okay, great. Now, tell me if you have any question on this. How we fix this? There is any doubt, because you need to work on the other program on your own. Then I will check later on, obviously. But I want you to understand the concept of classes and objects. First of all, define everything in the class body, and then the method will focus on specific things. If I say calculate area, it means calculate area will help you to calculate the area. Okay, display area will help you to display the area, right? Generally, that's what we do. We give a name to the method which should be sounding familiar to the activity that you are doing in that particular method body. Okay. So is it clear?
Yeah.
this program?
Yeah.
So see the value that you have given at the bottom to match the result.
Yeah, it matches.
Why it's saying plus? Have you given after plus, did you give any inverted comma or something? Plus should not be there. Okay, just give a space. Just give a space.
Yeah.
Now check it. Okay. Cool. So we are done with this. You got the task that you need to do tomorrow. The account and withdrawal, deposit and all. Got that? What you need to do?
Yeah.
So I'm also testing it here in the chat, so you can copy it, and yesterday's homework we will check tomorrow, because it's already a little late now. Okay, we will check that tomorrow. Okay. Stop it.
Okay,
this is all for today. See you tomorrow. Bye.
Thank you.